안녕하세요. 코인사이트의 송다솜입니다. 오늘은 이렇게 비욘드 블록스에 왔어요. 되게 우연한 기회에 아이캐시라는 프로젝트를 인터뷰를 하게 되는데요. 지금 제 옆에 계신 분은 진짜 유명하신 분이에요.
Go inside. iCash.
진짜 유명하신 분이에요. 맥도나라고 지금 아이캐시의 파운더시고요. 지금부터 인터뷰를 해보도록 하겠습니다. 집중해 주세요.
Go inside.
About your background until now.
Sure. So my career has been over the last 20 years. I worked in professional sports for the New England Patriots. I have a management company where I represent Tom Brady, American football player, Giselle, model. Work with the estate for Nelson Mandela, and always work with protecting trusts in the states like that. In 2007, I started a hedge fund of funds. With Avenue Capital and President Clinton, and did investing in debt and credit.
You mean President Clinton?
He was a partner in the fund, yeah.
Yeah.
And in 2010, I went to Goldman Sachs and managed the private capital of the partners of Goldman Sachs. Did that for several years. And then I left and started my own company called Atlas Mara, where we bought 8 banks in Africa. And then I took that public on the London Stock Exchange in 2014.
I guess.
What is iCash Projects? Why did you build the team the way you did?
Well, you know, from my career in building businesses all over the world, I have a profound appreciation for building teams of institutional quality. And it was very important for me to build the team first and to be able to have a team of people who have built and scaled businesses all over the world. So our president is based in Japan, who has 25 years of experience in Asia, who's a JD and MBA from Harvard and Columbia, worked for 25 years here for Panasonic, Credit Suisse, Deutsche Bank. Our chief technology officer lives in Seoul, named Ling King Ming. Ling is Chinese American from San Francisco, an expert coder. Our chief investment officer has a math degree from MIT, an original investor in the Ethereum project, and understands investing in the crypto markets. Our chief operating officer ran risk management for the $75 billion pension fund of Massachusetts and has a real appreciation for compliance and regulations, which is very important. So it was important for me to build a team that could interact with any party all over the world, be it a big bank, a big insurance company, or a big institutional investor. We wanted to be able to be prepared for that, and we're well structured for that.
I guess.
What is proof of trust and why is it needed?
So we created the proof of trust protocol because we realized that for global institutions to utilize blockchain, they need to know and they need to trust that the transactions are going to settle accurately. So we developed a protocol that can operate across different blockchains such that at the summation or at the settlement of any smart contract, you can contest the outcome and elevate it to a network of delegates or oracles that we cultivate so that they audit and affirm the accuracy of the settlement of the smart contract. So we can take the potential fail rate of a smart contract from 5% all the way down to 0.00000005%.
I guess.
Now let's take a deeper dive into proof of trust.
Sure, I'm happy to. We actually have very significant technology and are very proud of our protocol. The way that the proof of trust protocol works is in traditional smart contracts, you have two parties to a smart contract, and that smart contract is validated or verified by one independent anonymous third party. What proof of trust protocol allows for is if one of the participants in the contract disagrees with that settlement prior to it being irreversibly entered to the blockchain, you can contest that settlement and elevate it and elevate the data from the smart contract to a network of delegates who will audit and affirm it and vote their perspective on how they believe it should have settled And we have a delegate layer of 5 delegates that review it first, and they vote, and then a second layer of 9 delegates that are super delegates that only have perfect ratings and have only always accurately validated contracts before. And so long as 7 out of 9 of those delegates agree, mm-hmm. it prints to the blockchain. So it's multiple layers of checks and balances to assure that a smart contract is accurate before it's irreversibly entered to the blockchain.
Ooh. Who can be the delegator?
So we are developing networks of delegates mm-hmm. and partnering with global companies who have registered users with skill sets that are relevant to the sector of the smart contract. For example, we've recently signed a paperwork with Weather News, who has 500 million daily registered users across China. We can utilize any of those users to audit and affirm smart contracts about whether or not it rained in a province of China, or to hedge against the risk of water bills for big farms, or we can have PhD students from a school that are studying biology, and they can be specifically validating smart contracts that in the sciences. So we're building little communities that have expertise in whatever sector the smart contract is in, and we can call from them inputs into that validation.
Wow. Or the delegates, and then they can get the token, right?
Right. So when you enter into the smart contract, you escrow iCash tokens into the contract. Mm-hmm. And if you don't use the protocol, if we agree on the settlement, mm-hmm. you get that money back. Uh-huh. You get those tokens back. But if you don't agree with the settlement, you can activate the protocol, and those tokens get automatically distributed mm-hmm. to the delegates mm-hmm. to do that work and to do the audit and the affirmation. So you pre-fund the need for the insurance. If you don't use it, you get it back. But if you do need it, it's there and it's pre-funded, and that token immediately goes to the delegate network to make your wrong right.
Okay.
iCash!
This is a very sensitive question. Which smart contract platform do you like the most?
Well, I think, there's no doubt that Ethereum is the most developed and the most robust. We are deciding to build our protocol across all smart contract platforms. So we're building on Ethereum, we're building on EOS, we're building on Tendermint, we're building on Neo, we're building on Hashgraph, we're building on Cardano, because no matter what platform people want to originate and generate smart contracts on, we want to be able to embed our protocol into that contract and adjudicate settlements on that platform for those clients.
Cool.
iCash.
What would be the biggest industry for iCash?
We think that our protocol will be required by many industries, but our largest opportunity is probably in the insurance space. So we will partner with global insurance companies who want to underwrite and insure blockchain transactions, and our protocol will be required of the contracts that want to be insured, such that the global insurance company can take trust in the fact that the settlement of the contract will be correct. So they can then underwrite and insure that contract's validity.
Do you have any insurance company which now considering to label?
Yes, we're working with several global insurance companies. One of our advisors is from Marsh & McLennan, who's the largest insurance company in the world. And we're in active conversations with them about how they can operate on blockchain and with smart contract settlements. But a lot of work needs to be done.
Ooh, cool.
iCash!
Tell me about some of your advisors.
Sure, we have a bunch of actually local advisors here in Korea. Henry Chung, who runs Draper Athena in Korea, is a longtime venture capitalist, is an important partner of ours. We're working with Michael Cho, who is on the board of directors of Kakao. Michael's been a very valuable friend and partner of ours. It's been very important for us to have people locally that understand the local markets. Mm-hmm. So instead of having advisors that just put their name on anything, we actually have people who are investors who have invested in our project and are helping us with strategic partnerships all throughout the region.
So in Korea, the Kakao, Yellow Digital, and what else the other country?
Oh, so we have partnerships in Korea, Japan, Hong Kong, Beijing, Singapore, America, Canada, the United Kingdom, all over the world. We have 20 jurisdictions that we have partners in, law firms in, and our approved regulations in those local jurisdictions. So many projects just claim that they're a utility and don't get law firm approval or regulatory guidance. We have taken an extra year before we launched and went and got 20 different law firms in 20 different countries that have approved us so that we can sell our tokens to local investors fully legally and trade on global exchanges fully legally.
Fully legally. The last question is, can you tell me your roadmap?
Sure, we have a pretty aggressive roadmap, but we're able to do so because we have 53 full-time developers all across the world. So we, within 12 months, aspire to launch on Ethereum, EOS, and Tendermint, and be actively deployed across all three blockchains within 12 months.
iCash!
여러분, 아이캐시가 정말 이런 프로젝트인지 더 자세히 알아보게 돼서 정말 재밌었고요. 좀 기대가 되는 프로젝트입니다. 그냥 개인적으로. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
And then say goodbye to our subscriber.
Thank you to all my friends in Korea. We're very thankful for your support. One, two, three.
안녕!